This is not only a time for celebration, it's also a time to reflect on what this holiday is all about, to pay tribute to our fallen heroes, and to remember the servicemen and women who cannot be with us this year because they are standing post far from home, in Iraq, Afghanistan, and around the world. On world, called and emailed loved ones at Fort Hood, all expressing the same stunned reaction.
On our missions in Iraq and Afghanistan, your service, your readiness to make that same sacrifice is an inspiration to us and to every single American.
And so are your families. As First Lady,
because of that service, because of the honor and heroism of our troops around the world, our people are safer, our nation is more secure, and we are poised to end our combat mission in Iraq by the end of August, completing a drawdown of more than 90,000 troops since last January. America's longest continuous combat engagement. For the better part of a decade, our troops and their families. Earlier this week, I spoke about our way forward in Afghanistan. And I said that because of the extraordinary work of our men and women in uniform, civilians, and our coalition partners, we will soon begin bringing our troops home, just as we've begun doing in Iraq. Let's connect the hundreds of thousands of brave Americans coming home from Iraq and Afghanistan to businesses that need their incredible skills and talents.
We've got brave, skilled Americans returning from Iraq and Afghanistan.
We're taking the fight to Al-Qaeda and ending the war in Iraq and starting to bring our troops home from Afghanistan. But even as we put relentless pressure on Al-Qaeda, we're ending the war in Iraq and beginning to bring our troops home from Afghanistan. I was proud to announce that, as promised, the rest of our troops in Iraq will come home by the end of this year. And in last month, I announced that, as promised, we will end the war in Iraq by the end of this year. For nearly 9 years, our nation has been at war in Iraq. You see, after nearly 9 years, our war in Iraq is over. This includes our newest generation of veterans from Iraq and Afghanistan. We've ended the war in Iraq and brought our troops home. You see, the war in Iraq is over. This would not be another Iraq or Afghanistan. And thank you to all the heroes who have served since. Most recently, our 9/11 generation of veterans from Iraq and Afghanistan. Now, in fact, with the Iraq War over and the transition in Afghanistan, fewer of our men and women in uniform are deployed in harm's way than at any time in the last decade. We have Americans serving across Iraq, including our embassy in Baghdad, and we will do whatever is needed to protect our people. And retired Marine General John Allen, who during the Iraq War worked with Sunnis in Iraq as they fought to reclaim their communities from terrorists, will serve as our special envoy to help build and coordinate our growing coalition. Right now, they pose a threat to the people of Iraq, Syria, and the broader Middle East. And we celebrate our newest heroes from the 9/11 generation, our veterans from Iraq and Afghanistan.
The heinous terrorist attacks in Paris and Beirut, in Iraq and Nigeria.
Our airstrikes are hitting ISIL harder than ever in Iraq and Syria. In Syria and Iraq, ISIL is losing territory, and we're not going to stop until we destroy this terrorist organization. In Iraq, ISIL has now lost more than 40% of the areas it once controlled. In a relentless air campaign and support for forces in Iraq and Syria who are fighting ISIL on the ground has allowed us to take approximately 40% of the populated territory that ISIL once held in Iraq. ISIL's already used chemical weapons in Syria and Iraq. So, in Afghanistan, Iraq, Syria, and beyond, we'll stay relentless against terrorists like Al-Qaeda and ISIL. Almost 180,000 troops were serving in Iraq and Afghanistan, and Osama bin Laden was still at large. We brought home most of our brave troops from Iraq and Afghanistan, took bin Laden.
We will begin to responsibly leave Iraq to its people and forge a hard-earned peace in Afghanistan.
And whether it was the run-up to the Iraq War or the revelation of secret programs, Americans often felt like part of the story had been unnecessarily withheld from them. And that
today, some of those stones are found at the bottom of this hill in Section 60, where the fallen from Iraq and Afghanistan rest. The wounds.
I know some are about to be deployed to Iraq and Afghanistan. Many have just come back. Ask the soldiers he's visited on his many trips to Iraq and Afghanistan. John.
We will help Iraq train its security forces and develop its economy. But we got Afghanistan and Iraq and... But remember, that's less than we are projected to have spent on the war in Iraq.
And all my son, Attorney General Captain Biden, walked in the door from Iraq today. First thing you do is walk up and give me a kiss.
It's a part of our strategy to responsibly end the war by removing all American combat brigades from Iraq by next September, and of all of our troops from Iraq by the end of 2011. So the and I keep on trying to explain to people, look, I've got a war in Afghanistan. We haven't gotten the troops out of Iraq yet. I've got North Korea and Iran and, H1N1 flu and, so
we are helping the Iraqi people build a better future and leaving Iraq to the Iraqis.
A new GI Bill of Rights for the 21st century is beginning to help soldiers coming home from Iraq and Afghanistan to begin a new life in a new economy.
I reiterated my belief that Iraq will be more secure and more successful if there is a place for all Iraqi citizens to thrive, including all of Iraq's ethnic and religious groups.